Robert.
Good, Connor. I've had
some. Me and my girlfriend Alexis were traveling, and I went to a few really, really good festivals and had a great time and experienced that for the first time. And I wanted to bring that back home so people around me could enjoy something like that, because we don't have a whole lot of that stuff going on around here. I was invited into the Medicine Tribe Facebook group, and I'm not sure who invited me, but I was in it for about 2 months before I came up with the idea of the gathering, and I just made a post and asked if this was something that people were might be interested in, and the all the people that commented and messaged me and wanted to talk to me on the phone inspired me to really try to do it. I asked my parents if it was something I could do down here. They bought this property 5 years ago, and they ran with it along with me.
We can all set up this stuff and run cards.
Started off there, do you know the musician Nako and the band Medicine for the People? Okay, here we go. It's like, well, we're a connection and network on Facebook, so a social online community that shares a lot of truths and passions and movements and ideas and struggles, and we hold and strive to keep a consistency of being there for each other, even if we physically have never met. And within that, you meet a lot of really special people.
I'm Steve.
My name is Hannah Buckeye.
Stacy Hessler.
Terry Ford.
My name is Ethan McDonald.
Leo Castrens.
My name is Emily Sprints.
Kick Narden.
This is Chris Osborne.
My name is Garrett LaRue.
Matt. I go by Solchi.
Across the country, across the world now.
I am from Lafayette, Indiana, and I'm 30 years old.
I'm 21 years old, and I'm from St. Louis.
I'm 26. I'm from Knoxville, Tennessee.
I'm 17, and I'm from Plainville, Michigan.
25, and from Middlebury or Shipshawana, Indiana.
Central West End, St. Louis, Missouri.
I am from Lebanon, Indiana. I'm 26 years old.
Now 30 years old. Originally from the islands of Hawaii.
Born and raised in Massachusetts.
I am 43. I'm from Earth.
Who are actually really passionate, really, really, really passionate about doing something. On all levels of life, just doing. All these people are connecting deeply and making true connections where the longing and the need, the want, the urge, the passion to meet those people is getting stronger and stronger. Well, this is the gathering of the tribe. The tribe was created and started as a fan following, but turned into a legit movement. Garrett threw this idea out on the Medicine Tribe page, saying that he has land that he would like to have a camp out at. And when that happened, it was such at a pivotal time, which was like probably at this point a year and a half ago, when we first really started thinking about it, that we knew it was a pivotal time where there was a space and opportunity for someone to come and actually meet these people who you conversate with on a daily basis, essentially, in some cases, meet them in person and share space.
I see all you beautiful people doing things that make me move and in the movement, and this how we do with the music's in the speech.
Thank you.
colossals and fossils, black magic and the voodoo queen. Well, it's the trumpets playing loud.
Oh, the string.
I'm gonna sing in the streets, buy some drinks with tips we make. I live on now, sleep all day. I'm going down to New Orleans. Oh, oh,
oh, oh. It was a little bit of a journey from concept to actual, physical manifestation.
That's really interesting because the first year we didn't know what to expect. I mean, are they even coming? How many people are gonna come?
And the first day when everybody started showing up and I had 100 people on the property, it was surreal. I didn't expect that kind of a turnout. I didn't know what kind of people I was attracting to this. And ended up being perfect,
This is actually the first time I've ever been, and I am absolutely baffled at this experience because out of every festival I've ever been to, this is probably the most humbling, the most family-oriented, the most welcoming, and most of all, there's so much just love and spirit going on that there's, every intention is set correctly. I've seen nothing negative. All I hear is laughter and people just, really encouraging each other to be even more spiritual, to be more more themselves than ever.
It's very intimate. You get to meet every single person. It's like everybody is coming together in a small community. Yes, it's growing. It's always going to grow. But you're coming together in a small type of community and basically coming together as one. And I like it because you get to meet everyone. You get to make relationships with people that you're going to value for a long time, very long time.
Absolute bliss and comfortability for people to express themselves and unify. So it's wonderful.
Community. Love.
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 To love.
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 Strength. Trust. That's exactly what you feel here. It's exactly what you see.
It was difficult to kind of just go with the flow on everything, so I had a plan of the things I wanted to do, and I don't think any of them went through. Everything happened in a different way, but it just like this year, it really flowed together on its own. I was just anxious for nothing.
This is only our second year, and so the best expectation is no expectation. This is a gathering of like-minded people who are coming to share space with each other, to share our experiences, knowledge, wisdom, passions, truths, with the purpose of understanding that when that happens, magic happens, connection happens, synchronicities happen, seeds are planted, seeds are sprouted. It's really beautiful. They basically can come with just themselves and meet really special people who really want to learn, but also help others.
Hold on to your pants!
G4G is a non-profit. It's called Grateful for Grace. And essentially, it's an organization that was created to help other people help other people. And the way it was created was to help facilitate all things that are considered to be sustainable. Right now we're doing a 3-month summer tour, sponsoring a 3-month summer tour, I should say, where we're taking people that want to learn about sustainability, what it means to them, to communities that are currently working towards being sustainable, if not are completely self-sustainable right now. Trying to create a learning experience and building a bridge between the world that doesn't know and the world that does.
Man, I personally have joined a group of other artists to create a collective called the Patchwork Hearts Collective. And together we believe in sharing our heart and uniting for a cause. And really what we've done is we're learning to use our art, which is the thing that we really know most and we feel most strongly about, to raise social and environmental awareness and to bridge gaps and to build connections and a network of people to tighten this idea of unity we all talk about so much.
We are building a small self-sustained community on our property. We have total about 11 acres, and we're wanting to build like earth homes and sweat lodges and stuff like that, and just like a retreat for people to come who've, you know, been on the road or who've, you know, had a crappy hand in life and just need a change. And people can come there and explore and, you know, learn what it means to really live.
Then we also have Red Bull Revival providing free food on behalf of their love and energy and wanting to keep everyone energized to continue creating the magic.
From the first gathering in October to this gathering now in June, the whole dynamic changed because of the time of the year. Last year it was cold and rainy, and this year it's warm and rainy.
So please set an intention for yourself, whether it's for this very moment, this evening, this weekend, this year. Be gentle with your thoughts tonight. Be gentle with your words. And remember that as you shine your light this evening and tomorrow, you're reflecting that light back to the person that you are looking at. You're giving everyone here permission to be their authentic self.
My vision of community is a cohesive, flowing group of people that live in harmony together, that work together to achieve all the same basic needs that we all need, and that is to take care of our family.
I would love to see a place that we can all really thrive and support each other through health and spirituality as much as possible.
It's a practice. Life is a practice. And if our intention is to practice mindfully, then we'll get better results.
Sacred space. And let's rock and roll.
Ow!
Souls are touching other souls, and changes are being made in friendships, and I feel like that's the big difference. I am now, compared to 2 years ago, I'm completely different. I've always struggled with a lot of anxiety and depression issues. Now, I feel like I've learned how to combat those feelings with, you know, positive words and understanding of other people's feelings, whether, you know, I agree with them or not. And I feel like some of that's contributed from the people I've met through the Medicine Tribe. Happiness for me is being with my family, having 4 children and a girlfriend, and having them all at home and, you know, sitting around the dinner table. That's where I am most blissful.
What does the world need the most?
What the world needs the most is for it to be healed and for the people to be healed. So I guess first it's the people, and then it's the earth, because I don't think that we can heal the earth if we ourselves are not first healed, because then maybe we don't see that the earth needs to be healed as well. So we just have to really take care of humanity, animals, and the planet, and so that we will still be able to be here and eat and drink and be healthy and free.
It's not a festival. This is like a gathering of family. This is like a reunion, you know? This is like really bringing together the light and love that we all know is within us, and having a moment together, and then taking what we learn here and going back out into the world, and then bringing back what we learned, and then doing it again. And there's no reason not to bring somebody along next time, you know? Bring something else to share, something else, a new idea, a new anything to move the movement, so that we understand what real possibilities are coming.
I feel like by the time everybody left last year, we all knew each other. There wasn't anybody that was left out or, you know, excluded from any part of it. I gave Leo a hug at the end of it, and like I got all teary-eyed, you know, and it was horrible, and I didn't want to leave, and it was sad, kind of, you know, but I knew I'd be seeing him again.
It was the perfect weekend. It really was. But it's one of those things where not many words can truly explain what is happening here at the gathering. It has to be felt and experienced for themselves to truly feel it and understand why something like this needs to exist, or why they were called to this, because they needed to feel that in their life. People come here to heal, people come here to share, people come here to release, people come here to love. Now they're seeing someone genuinely pursue what they believe is their truths, with fear, but also courage and vulnerability.
the fear isn't enough to stop them. They go for it. And so, we celebrate our purpose.
At the gathering of the tribe, at the gathering of the tribe.